ירושלים של סב ושל נחוש ושל עוד על עוד כל שירייך אני כירור ירושלים של סב ושל נחוש ושל עוד על עוד כל שירייך Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Robert Crook, and I welcome you to this beautiful Jewish ceremony of the Chuppah. I'm glad to see so many smiles here as we welcome here bridal party, groom, his parents, our beautiful brides, and her parents. gentlemen, at this point, I would like to ask you to rise as we welcome here the beautiful brides and her parents. Before you bring your beautiful bride here, make sure you see right. Take a look. Take a look. Yes or not? Tell everybody yes or not. I feel it's good. Okay, if you're sure, can you bring her to the chuppah? Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a beautiful groom and bride some big round of applause. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please take your seats. Robbie, you're too far from your bride. Come on, she's almost yours. So finally, as you're standing here, this beautiful weather, beautiful people, beautiful friends around you. And I would like to welcome you to my first prayer. It's called Bruchim Abayim, which is mean, blessed are you who have come here in the name of God. We serve our God with joy, come into God's presence with the song, as we all rejoice that Rachel and Robert join in marriage in the presence of God and loved ones. Some glorious and blessed God, grant your blessing to the bride and groom as you, surrounded by your family and friends, whose joy and prayer are with you here as you stand here on this chuppah, the symbol of the Jewish home. This chuppah is fragile but not permanent. Your union will be strong and everlasting. Your home will be a shelter against the storm of life and heaven of peace and serenity. As we begin the ceremony with a blessing, it's another blessing, it's a cold welcoming blessing, Bruchim Abayim. As you finally reach this day, for how long are you waiting for this day? Robert, do you remember?
Got engaged about a year ago.
So it's almost like 12 months. Right. So, it's a long time, but you have a long way to go. So, this is why we believe at this point we need something that really celebrate your simcha, your celebration. And believe it or not, what is the symbol of this joy tonight is this bottle of wine. is Chardonnay. And this is a symbol of joy. So we have a special cup here. It's called Kiddush cup. So this Kiddush cup is come up for the world. Kadosh is mean holy one. But before we have this cup of wine, I will recite this special prayer.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Shehecheyanu vekiyemanu vehikiyanu lasemanase.
So now it's time to fill this cup of wine all the way to the top. So this first cup of wine is a blessing. As we believe in this Kiddush cup, this holy cup, as you start your journey together. This is what first blessing of this cup of wine, which you're going to sooner or later to join together at home every Shabbos, every Shabbat, as you're going to fill the cup of this cup of wine and share it together, as you're going to share it now.
Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Boreh Peri Hagafen. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kiddushanu B'Mitzvotav V'Tzivanu Lanu Riyun V'Asalanu Resul V'Iktiru Lanu Nisvot Lanu L'Nedach Chuppa V'Kiddushim. Baruch Atah Adonai Mekadesh Amo Yisrael Al Yedei Chuppa V'Kiddushim.
Okay, can I make a one seat? Rabbi, you have to share this cup of wine. She's thirsty. Come on. Yes. Yes. Just make it one sip. Yes. Okay. So at this point, Robert, and you, beautiful bride, Rachel, I want you to ask you some very important questions. So hopefully you're ready to answer. You feel like you know what to say, right? Let's try. Do you, Robert, take this beautiful bride, Rachel? Look at her, she's beautiful, right? Do you take her to be your beloved wife? Do you promise to cherish and protect her, whatever in good fortune or an adversity, and to seek together with her alive, hello, by the faith of Moses and Israel? If so, can you tell to all your guests and your parents?
I do.
Finally, he said, I do. Let's give him a bigger round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. He said, I do. Oh. Rachel, may I ask you the same question? Do you take this handsome young man, look at him, he's beautiful, right? Yes, smile, to be your beloved husband, and do you promise to cherish and protect him, whatever in good fortune or in adversity, and to seek together with him alive, hallowed by the faith of Moses and Israel? If so, please tell him.
I do. I do.
Let's give him a big round of applause. I do. Why not? So, if so, the best man is somewhere here and has some very important piece of art here, right? Do you have something very special on? You kept this in safe place? Okay, so we have two wedding bands. So I want you to exchange these rings. So Robbie, you know this, which is, yes. No. So So as you place this ring on index finger of your bride, hold it, don't crush her finger, please, be careful. And look at her beautiful eyes. So you're going to repeat after me the vows in Hebrew and English.
Are at mekudeshet li betabat zo kidat Moshe v'Israel. With this ring, be consecrated to me as my wife, according to the law of Moses and Israel.
So now, at this point, Rachel, as you take this ring and look at him and repeat after me this ancient vows.
Are ata mikudash li betabat zo kidat Moshe v'Israel. With this ring, be consecrated to me as my husband, according to the law of Moses and Israel.
Very good. So, I believe you have some personal vows to say to each other. So who's going to be first? Okay, so.
Yeah. Rachel, alas, it's our wedding day. A day that is so symbolic of taking this giant step together. And while I recognize this, it's ironic, because in many ways, it feels like we've been married for years. In COVID years, I can't even comprehend the amount of time we've spent together, basically attached at the hip. When I originally wrote this, I included a note about how we, and I emphasize we, can spend unlimited time together and truly never get sick of each other. Then I realized I needed to tweak that. After all, you do put up with my routines and structure, quirks, sports obsessions, such as the obligatory post-game sports debriefs on the phone with my brother, and I could keep going, but I'll leave it at that. It's been such a crazy and unpredictable run these past several years. In this COVID merry-go-round between Miami, Avon, Connecticut, in a small countryside cottage in rural New York, I've realized it doesn't matter what's going on in the world or where in the world we are. Just being with you truly brings out my happiest life and my best self. I'm so attracted to your beautiful looks, but I'm truly just as attracted to the person you are. Your selflessness, your kindness, how genuinely happy of a person you are. You really are a special soul and make my life so complete. I did want to revisit a few moments. I think back to February 2020, 2 weeks into my first solo apartment, and a global pandemic breaks out to create the ultimate inflection point. You, of course, had gone down to Miami. I could stay in New York, where my family and closest friends all reside, or make the shotgun decision to basically move in with you in a new state in the backdrop of this pandemic uncertainty. This moment stands out to me because despite all of that uncertainty, I was certain that if I was gonna be locked in, I was gonna be locked in with you. I'd be remiss if I didn't mention how your entire family has truly embraced me as part of the family. I think back to step two of our pandemic journey, returning to the Northeast, which also meant temporarily moving in with your family. I can safely say, as a 30-year-old working adult, moving with the in-laws for any amount of time was not quite on my bucket list. But fast forward 2 months, and I found myself feeling totally at home, arguably too much at home, walking around the kitchen in my bathrobe, and of course uttering those famous words to your mom, "So, Diana, what are you thinking for dinner tonight?" They say when you marry your wife, you marry a family, and I'm so appreciative of the relationships I have with your family. Rachel, I really do pinch myself at how lucky I feel to have found my perfect match. You're such a beautiful human being. I couldn't be happier to spend my life with you. I truthfully cannot even imagine spending my life without you. I vow to always be there for you, to love you through the smooth times and any bumpy roads along the ride, to raise a family with you, and always appreciate how special you are and how happy you make me.
Thank you. What about you, Rachel? Do you have something to say? So can you help? She wants to see you, you know, your eyes. Can you open her veil, please? Yes. Okay, perfect. So the microphone is yours.
The stress is more functional than you would think. Every now and then, you stop what you're doing. You look at me and say, "Did you think a night out at Paul's would lead to this?" And my response always is no. Mostly because no one expects to meet the person they plan to spend the rest of their life with at a New York City nightclub. But I also had no idea what I was getting into. I saw a tall, dark, handsome, successful, suave Jewish boy wearing a scarf indoors. And my first thought was, oh boy, this guy is trouble. But we couldn't ignore all of the degrees of connection between us, from my high school trip with your roommate's sister, who happened to be taking out my brother's ex that same night that we met, to later finding out we just missed each other at the venue prior. We had to explore more, and it was the best decision we could have ever made because we fell in love. There is more to you than meets the eye. I love that you're deeply caring, not just for me, your family, and Brucey, but for your friends. We all know Robbie will be there for us because he cares deeply. You have a special gift of allowing everyone around you to feel comfortable. People can be themselves around you, but it's also a two-way street. You make yourself comfortable everywhere you go. Sunny Isles, Wading River, and Avon, Connecticut. You are quick-witted, magnetic, practical, smart, hilarious, a prankster, a family man, and a genuinely kind human being that's graced my life. Beyond giving me companionship and keeping me entertained around the clock, you've also changed me in the years we've known each other. I've never been one to keep a routine. My family can testify here. I am okay without structure. But having a routine with you has been one of the most grounding additions to my life. My days would not be complete without your wake-up call, bringing a Brucey up onto our bed, Starbucks run, and straight to the dog park, nightcaps with episodes of our favorite sitcom, turning on the two air purifiers in the room. These are all the small things that we repeat each and every day that actually make a world of difference. To paraphrase my grandfather, Dieta Sasha's wise advice, Rachel, when looking for your husband, prioritize your potential for future growth. Robbie, I couldn't ever imagine finding someone like you. Someone that I'm beyond excited to learn and grow with. And with that, in addition to being your trusted partner, I vow to do my best to be the person you need to grow and live a fulfilled life. So here we are. You proposed to me where I spent my childhood summers, on the beach in Wading River. Now we're right near the place you grew up. in the same town your parents got married, reading our vows to one another. Do you think a night at Paul's would lead to this? I love you.
Beautiful, beautiful. Thank you. Thank you, Rachel. Thank you, Robert. So, and not, it is time to recite not one, but the seven blessings. It's called Sheva Brachot. And through the ages, bride and grooms have been blessed with the seven special wedding blessings. Six of these blessings, God was created the world, man and woman, peace and harmony, and especially the joy of the bride and groom. The seventh, the last one, is chant the blessing over the wine. It is the first cup, the second cup that you will share as a husband and wife. It sanctifies this day and this marriage. As you have shared this cup of wine, you now undertake to share all that the future may bring. May you find life's joys doubly gladdened and bitterness is sweetened in all things hallowed by the true companionship and by love. As we fill this cup of wine again, Robert, do you mind to hold this cup? But don't drink it. Okay. Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Shehakol Bara Lechvodo. Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Yotzer Adam. Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Yatzar Adam Betzalamo, Betzelen El Mutav Anito, Vektin Lo Mimenu Ben Yahadeyar. Baruch Adonai Yotzer Adam. Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Bara Sason V'Simcha, Chata V'Chala Gil Arin Aditza V'Chevta, Ahava V'Ahava Shalom V'Rehut. Mehra Adonai Eloheinu Yishama Be'ar Yehuda U'V'Chutzot Yerushalayim. Sosta kol v'simcha kol chatan v'kala kol mishalot chatanim v'chatim unorim misheni konatam baruch atah Adonai mesameh chatan im hakala. Can first you, can you share it with your beautiful bride? At this point, I would like to present to you this beautiful ketubah. Ketubah is a Jewish certificate of marriage. It's beautiful orange. Whose choice was here? Rachel, is yours, or you will choose this ketubah? Of course, you. And I would like to read this ketubah, but what's important, on the top of this ketubah, I will show you later, it says, Ani le dodi ve dodi li. These words, what does mean? You are my beloved, and my beloved is yours. This is what you promised to each other. It says here, on the first day of the week, the 27th day of the month of Sivan, in the year 5782, which is corresponding to 25th day of the June, in the year 2022, here in Mamaroneck, New York, United States of America, in the presence of family and friends, the beloved Robert David Abrams, son of Jonathan and Ellen, and Rachel Jessica Everson, daughter of Joseph and Diana, entered in the covenant of marriage. As you promised, your journey, you promised to love, cherish, encourage, and inspire one another. Your hearts be filled together, creating unique bonds with friendship and companionship at its core. Through the union, you have to value the support of each other, always striving to show sensitivity to each other's needs, to show nurture and another emotionally, spiritually, and intellectually, always the courage as you promise to live your life together for many years. a life as a partners. You shall strive to build a home committed to you, to our Jewish heritage, a home of love, peace, tolerance, and charity. Through each other's eyes, you see the world anew. It may be better together. All it is valid. And signed by two of your witnesses and myself. So I want you to show this beautiful ketubah to your guests. Ladies and gentlemen, please, let's give a big round of applause, please. A beautiful ketubah, beautiful certificate of marriage. So this ketubah, okay, will be one day and in your bathroom, somewhere in a nice place, to remind you what you have to do as a husband. You know what I have to do as a husband? I will tell you later, okay. So, it is now my prayers. It's called Ribbono Shel Olam, the Heavenly Creator. We thank you, praise you for gift of eternal life and beauty, meaningful worth. Surely God, no more precious, more fulfilling than the gift of love. As two young people, as Rachel and Robert, I'm come here to make a covenant of love discovered in each other. Today, here before the family and friends, they pledge to commit themselves to share life's journey. This day, may they enter upon the life that will be a blessing, a source of happiness to them and all who love them. As we say, blessed are you, our God, who does unite bride and groom. Zeha yom asa Adonai negila banis mechabo. This is the day that God has made, and let us glad and rejoice and bless both of you. And this to bless both of you, we have here something very special. I have in my hand, it's called talit or talis, a special Jewish garment which usually a boy wearing the first time in his life on day of his bar mitzvah. And believe it or not, Robert wear this talit on his bar mitzvah day. And this talit was waiting to this very special day. And I would like to bless both of you under this very special talit. But I would like to invite your fathers, come forward, please. So you face to me, please. So now, this is called Birkat Kohanim, the priestly benediction. This is my prayer, my blessing to you tonight. Robert, may God bless you. They keep you alive and healthy. Rachel, may God's presence be with you, give you strength, love, and happiness. And may God's presence be with you the rest of your life and give you his most precious gifts, the gift of love, health, and shalom. And let us all together, let us say, Amen. So, this is the time, this very special time that you was waiting for some time. Are you ready? Okay. So, it's my honor, first of all, to be with you on this beautiful day. It is my honor, by the power vested in me, but we need something special. Do you have something for me? I need your help. Oh, Rachel already, she's in the church, you know what to do. Can you face to each other, please? Can you place on the floor? So, okay, now is the time by the power vested in me by the state of New York and according to the law of Moses and Israel, Robert and Rachel, I now pronounce you as a husband and wife. You can bring the glass. Mazel tov! Rise, everybody, let's give him some big round of applause and scream Mazel Tov and Robin Rye. Sing my tov, Mazel Tov, sing my tov, Mazel Tov, Mazel Tov, sing my tov, yeah, thank you.
excited? So this is what we're gonna do. When we go out there, we're gonna make an entrance. Jump, scream, dance, do whatever comes to your heart. But do it with love and energy for Robbie and Rachel, okay? Good evening, friends and loved ones, and welcome to Rachel and Robbie's wedding celebration! My name is Gennaro, and I have the honor of serving as your MC for tonight's celebration, alongside this amazing man, ladies and gentlemen, Anastasia, Ivan, DJ, Teddy P. Give them a round of applause! Now, before we get started, I want to check the excitement in the room. Where's Robbie's side of the family? Where's Rachel's side of the family? That sounds incredible. We are super excited to pack this dance floor tonight. But before we get started, I'd like to give a shout out to some of those people who travel near and travel far. Give it up for Connecticut. Where's Connecticut in the house? Massachusetts! Michigan! Where's Michigan? Michigan! All right, we love you, Michigan. Where's San Francisco? We have somebody from South Korea, Shanye! Westchester! Where's New York City? Hey, Teddy, you think we're ready? Okay, let's do it, man. Our first couple I'm about to introduce just celebrated their 41st anniversary on July 11th. They got married in the Marinette, New York, which is right where we are. Please give it up and give a warm welcome to Robbie's parents, Jonathan and Ellen! Might know on October 4th, they will be celebrating their wedding anniversary of 35 beautiful years together. Please help me welcome Rachel's parents, Joseph and Diana! Somebody scream! So we're gonna go on to our groomsmen. Are you ready to bring in the beautiful, handsome groomsmen? Grandpa. Don't let anybody tell him he's not the best man. Best friends since childhood, roommates for years, and a personality the size of this wedding. Give it up for Abe Cooper! Groomsman, the ultimate friend and confidant, fellow Georgetown alumni in the house, give it up for Will Skolnick. Coming up next, he's a gentle giant, a friend since elementary school, and their weddings are 1 month apart. Dude, now go get that SK Fund closed! Big Ben Baevski! Come on, give it up for Big Ben! Yeah.
Our next groomsman is Robbie's longest friend. They go way back to the third grade. This guy will rock the boat and get this party started. Please give a big warm welcome to Steve D'Amelia! Come on, Steve, show us what you got, baby. Our next VIP, they go back to middle school, and no one traveled further to be here with Robbie today. All the way from South Korea, give it up for Sean Ye! Somebody scream! All right, check this out. This next VIP is family. Is a friend, a groomsman, he checks all three. Family, friend, groomsman. And he's a surgeon and probably on call as we speak. Give it up for Dr. Paul Yolfi! Yeah! Now it's time for our beautiful bridesmaids. Are you ready for the beautiful bridesmaids? I can't hear you. Are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, our first bridesmaid was Rachel's friend. First friend in New York City. Since she moved to California and flew 6 hours to be here. I hope she flew business, man. I mean, what up with the airlines these days? Please help me welcome Siri Prasad. Our second bridesmaid is a close family friend. Rachel has known Ariel since she was 4 years old. Please welcome Ariel Sternfeld! Now Rachel's former roommate turned closest friend. Rachel and her were hitting the town the night Rachel met Robbie. Oh, do tell, baby. Please welcome Marley Cohen. You got stories, right? She's got stories. Just the fire and drink is just. Both Rachel and Gloria attended university in Switzerland together. Their friendship took off on an academic trip to Scotland. They became the closest of friends after college in New York City. Help me welcome Gloria Dumas. Come on, somebody scream! Rachel's best friend from university in Switzerland. These ladies were attached at the hip, gallivanting through Europe. Please help me welcome Jasmine Brown. All right, guys. Now it's time to bring out some of our VIPs. The doctor, the brother, the best man, the best friend. Please welcome Jeff Abrams and his beautiful wife, Ilana! Let's go! Put your hands up! It is time for our maid of honor, Rachel's sister and sister-in-law to Robbie, a.k.a. the youngest child, a.k.a. the soon-to-be Boston University graduate, a.k.a. the one who keeps this entire family entertained. She is escorted by the firstborn, the new brother-in-law. But don't stop on formalities. The running joke is that the only one inseparable as Robbie and Rachel are Robbie and Josh. They even share their clothes on family vacations. So please, give it up for our maid of honor and the brother of the bride, Lily, escorted by Josh Emerson! All right, ladies and gentlemen. Now, the reason why we're all here. I need everybody to get up. Everybody stand up right now. This is what we're going to do. I need everybody to stand up and come a little closer. I want you to be surrounding this dance floor as we welcome our couple tonight. Come on to the dance floor. All around the perimeter of the dance floor. Get a little closer. Make them feel some love. That's it. Around the perimeter of the dance floor, everybody. But clear this path right here. We need this path open. Anywhere you can fit. Come on in, everybody. Okay, guys. Let's clear this area once everybody's here. Ladies and gentlemen, the moment we're all here for, moment we've all been waiting for. I need you guys to go absolutely nuts. Are you with me? Are you with me? Please welcome our newlyweds. For the first time, as husband and wife, Robbie and Rachel.
Yeah. se shalom midromar. Hu yase shalom aleinu ve'akom al Yisrael. Eiru, iru amen. Hu yase shalom midromar. Hu yase shalom aleinu ve'akom al Yisrael. Eiru.
Now everybody, put your hands together and go to the right. Go to the right. Let's sit circle going. Everybody to the right. To the right. You can do it. You can do it.
Shalom aleinu, Abba Israel. Yasi shalom. Yasi shalom. Shalom aleinu, Abba Israel. Yasi shalom. Yasi shalom. Shalom aleinu, Abba Israel. Yasi shalom. Yasi shalom. Shalom aleinu, Abba Israel.
I need some strong men out there. I need you to come out with the chairs, guys. Robbie, Rachel. I need some strong guys. Hey, hold on. All right, this is what we're going to do. Guys, slow down for a second. Slow down. Put them together. I want you to go.
Taste it. Come on, people. People. we'd like to invite everybody to get back to your seats, have a drink. Your appetizers are on the table. Enjoy, ladies and gentlemen.
Borach ate Adonai, Eloheinu, melech olam, hamotzo lechem min haaretz.
Amen. Everybody together. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Wait, then we gotta cut the bread. Деда, дедушка, иди сюда. Okay, we gotta cut the bread. Деда, иди сюда. We gotta slice the bread. Or just break it with your hand. It's tradition. Break a piece of bread, and you have to eat it. A little bit of salt. Is there salt here? Break a piece of bread. L'chaim, everybody! Thank you.
Breath away, stunning, congratulations. outside and share this absolutely most beautiful and spectacular day. We could not have imagined this day without your presence here. Thank you. I'd like to thank Ellen and Johnny for sharing Robbie with us, raising him to be the perfect other half of our father. Where are the parents? To all of our family, friends, colleagues, we've all watched each other's kids grow and blossom into amazing humans. It is extra special and emotional that you're here to celebrate with us. I want to shout out to the Abrams clan. Hi, Abrams clan. That's a big clan. Robbie, Rachel, you got a, it's a big clan. It runs in Robbie's family. And Robbie's and Rachel's friends and colleagues, hello. Hi, everyone. Great to meet all of you. Thank you for coming. All the young people, you simply take my breath away. You look gorgeous. And the older I get, the more beautiful you get. Truly. So thank you for coming. It's great to see you all. So I'll let you in on a little secret. As many of you already know, Rachel and Robbie met at Paul's Casablanca in New York City over 3 years ago. But not many of you are aware that this union almost did not happen. Rachel had no intention of following up with a date after that initial visit. I obviously stepped in to make it happen, told her, what do you have to lose? So here's my conversation with Rachel. Hi, Rach, how are you? What did you do last night? And Rachel answered, oh, I went out with a few friends, ran into this guy, and all other funny details of her evening. Me, do you intend on going on a date with this guy? Rachel, no. You see, he's a tall, handsome, and successful finance guy in New York City. So this was, and that's a red flag for me, Mom. So this was a first for me. My daughter is not going on a date with a guy, not because he's not tall, dark, and handsome, and smart, but precisely because he is tall, dark, handsome, and smart. Hmm, I thought. I erased that one well. So the aphorisms are a lot. I mean, a lot to handle. As Rachel said, Mom, not sure how Robbie will react to us, we're a lot to handle. There's 5 of us, there's two large dogs, and a cat that brings mice from outside and chases them around the house. At times we're loud, opinionated, ethnic, always energetic, and always lots going on. But as it turns out, Robbie, except for the ethnic part, is pretty much the same. And so Robbie fit right in. The very first time Robbie came to meet us in Avon, Connecticut. So here's the visual. Here's the visual. A young man comes to meet his girlfriend's parents for the first time. He's wearing 3/4 length sweatpants and a t-shirt, does not exhibit any symptoms of shyness, and totally makes himself at home. He flops down on our family's couch, stretches out his legs, and is totally relaxed. And that's how it was from day one, and that's how it is still. Robbie seamlessly blended in. Rachel and Robbie, you are a true team. You bring out the best version of each other. You share the same values. You're each other's best friend and partner. Robbie, like a true soldier, fights the battles, but Rachel, in true regal way, quietly and with great finesse, wins the war. Robbie has coined a name for it, but I can't say it out loud. So Rachel and Robbie, you've been acquiring titles throughout your union. Boyfriend, girlfriend, fiance, bride, groom, husband, wife. So I'd actually like to raise a toast, everyone, to both of you, and to many, many long and happy years together. We love you unconditionally and plan on being there every step of the way. Hopefully acquiring a few more titles for ourselves. Grandma and grandpa. Cheers to you, to your love, to happiness and success, till 1 point. A minimum till 1 point.
Cheers.
One more thing. Rachel and Robbie asked us not to play Russian music. It's too ethnic, they said. So we were forced to go behind their backs and ask Gennaro to sing about 40% of his repertoire in Russian.
Sorry, guys. They paid me big money for that.
So they kind of taste for it. Just kidding. Everyone who worked really hard behind the scenes to make this evening happen. Bob, where's Bob? Our event director. Gennaro and Bob. Gennaro and his staff. Yeah, and his team. The photographer, the videographer, the flower person. We thank you all, and we couldn't have done this without you. We're looking for a great evening. This is just the start. Enjoy, get your dancing feet on. We're gonna rock this evening.
Yeah, give it up for Deanna.
Cheers.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I'm going in with my husband is this plan. So this is a surprise. I'll get you that.
And you can borrow mine, Joseph.
So I knew I'm not going to be able to top the speech, so I didn't try. I decided not to go low, but to go different. Also, apology for Russian ethnic. I did try to put English words to it, but I have not rehearsed it, so we're gonna give it a go.
Something special is about to happen.
I have no idea what's
going on. Let me see that mic. I'm going to need a mic stand. Deanna, this one I need you to hold on his guitar.
So fast, our little Rachie going to leave her nest. She and her teammate Robbie ready to spread their wings. So let us bless their journey, wishing them happy things, sunny days, quiet nights, peaceful life, easy fights, falling in love forever, staying forever friends. Live every day with passion, But if your life gets hard, face all your storms together and never grow apart. World can be very twisted, life tries to break you down, but if you stick to basics, you always come around. Healthy kids, faithful friends, nice and lost, also helps. Falling in love forever, staying forever friends. What? What's going on here?
Hey, you didn't say your dad was going to come along and steal the show. That's amazing. One more round of applause for Joseph and Deanna, mom and dad. Rachel's mom and dad. That was beautiful. Wow. I know what's happening right now. Robbie, your mom is over there going like, how the hell am I going to like do that? I can't. Ellen, where are you, hon?
Yeah, Ellen.
Ellen, I want to bring Ellen. And I want to bring out Jonathan. Give him a round of applause. Robbie's mom and dad. All right, there she is. She said she was gonna dance tonight, man. She's not messing around. Yeah. This is your first dance, go ahead. So ladies and gentlemen, one more time. Who's going first? Okay, round of applause for Jonathan, everybody.
Wow, I gotta tell you, when you gotta follow, and again, when you gotta follow an act like that, it's better to remain silent and be thought a fool than to speak up and remove all doubt. Joseph, that was incredible, unbelievable. That was really beautiful, incredible. Folks, I really want to welcome everybody here tonight. It's just amazing to have you all here. You know, 41 years ago, almost to the day, I flew into town as a young graduate student at the University of Illinois, and Robbie, your mother and I were married just a couple of hundred meters on that side of the sound. And it really gives me, it's very touching and moving to see so many of you who were at our wedding 41 years ago. It's just an incredible thing to see. You know, the Abrams family, the Finkelstein family, we're pretty big families. On the Abrams side, we have, just for the record, Robbie, if your grandparents were here, who I know you adored and loved, they are watching, and they are present at this celebration. And the Abrams family, there are four of us. We have 10 grandchildren, 20 great-grandchildren in Talatin. It's a pretty amazing family. And the Finkelstein family, four children, 12 grandchildren, and 16 great-grandchildren in Talatin. And you know, when you have such a big family, there's a lot of folklore, there's a lot of history that develops, and as my brother Dennis will know, my brother Keith has a unique sense of humor, and 41 years ago, after our wedding, he called Ellen aside and said, you know, Ellen, it takes 5 years to get full Abrams citizenship, but Keith, I'm going to exercise executive privilege Rachel, as of half an hour ago, you are a full-fledged member of the Abrams family. You know, conversely, here we are in Westchester County, Marinette Harrison, and I guess this is Ellen's legal side of her, and we always have a rebut. Over the years, our families, we were very interested in politics, it happens all the time, but in our family, local politics is first and foremost in all discussions. And Ellen has always said to me, you know, whenever I comment on local Harrison politics, Ellen turns around and says to me, you know, it takes 5 years to become a citizen of Harrison. And that 5 years turned into 10 years and 15 years, and I'm still waiting. But Robbie, I got to tell you, when you move to Harrison with Rachel, your mom will give you executive privilege, and you'll be members of Harrison from day one. Enough of the family, so that people understand where we're coming from. I just want to say a few words about Robbie and Rachel. And it's funny to hear Diana and Joseph, who we've got to know and love over this period of time. A wonderful, wonderful family, wonderful people. We really enjoyed being with them, working with them. But I got to tell you, slightly different nuance, but Ellen and I got a call from Robbie in 2019, and Robbie said to me, Dad, I have met this amazing girl, amazing woman, and I'm so excited I'm taking her out on a date. And Robbie was on the speakerphone, and Ellen looked at me, and I looked at Ellen. I knew what Ellen was thinking, and she probably knew what I was thinking. Fast forward a couple of months, when we got to meet Rachel, Robbie brought her over to our home for a barbecue, and I caught the first glimpse of Rachel, and I looked at Ellen, and Ellen looked at me, and I know Ellen said a prayer, and I said a prayer. And I gotta tell you, there is somebody up there that listens and answers our prayers. It's amazing. You know, Rachel, you are a beautiful young woman. You're intelligent, you're poised, you're calm. You are just absolutely amazing. And Rachel, you bring out so much of the best of Robbie. It's just, as a mother, as Ellen and I will testify, it's just a wonderful thing to see. You are absolutely incredible. And we are so happy, so proud, both Ellen and I, to call you my daughter-in-law. And same goes for Ellen. Truly blessed. It's a wonderful thing. Now, I want to keep this thing short, but when it comes to Robbie, you know, I can go on for a long period of time. Those of you who are at Robbie's Bar Mitzvah have heard the story. I don't even have to add to it. Robbie, the people, your family, your friends, the people that you work for, know exactly everything about you, so I'm not going to go on and tell everyone, yeah. But Robbie, you have many amazing qualities, and one of your qualities is you are incredibly loyal. You're incredibly loyal to your family, to your friends, and to the people that you work with. It's an amazing and wonderful thing, and I know you will bring that to Rachel for the rest of your life, because that's you, Robbie. And any speech about Robbie without mentioning the Atlanta Braves would not be a speech, because those of you who know Robbie know that that's Robbie's passion. And anyway, when Robbie moved, we moved to from Atlanta to New York. Robbie entered the Harrison Elementary School. Robbie would go to school, come home, and you know, defending the Braves, he would land up in fights. There are a number of the kids over here, Robbie's groomsmen, that were the recipient and vice versa of these scraps. And just tell you a little story. In 1999, in the great heyday of the Atlanta Braves teams, Robbie was at school late on Friday afternoon, and I was watching the Rays play the Houston Astros in the playoffs. So, watching this game, I decided I had to call the principal of the Harrison Avenue Elementary School. So I got the principal's office, and I said to the principal, to secretary, could you please give Robbie a message? I said, yes, absolutely. I said, please let Robbie know that the Braves have taken the lead in the top of the sixth of a three-run home run by Brian Jordan. Brian Jordan is one of Robbie's childhood heroes, loved him. That night when I got home, Robbie comes to me in tears. Dad, how could you do this to me? What did you do? I looked at Robbie, I said, Rob, what are you talking about? Robbie hands me a letter. I open the letter from the principal of the Harrison Elementary School. It says, Mr. Abrams, while we appreciate your son's admiration of the Atlanta Braves, don't you ever waste school resources and ever call again and give him a baseball score. Robbie, fast forward to last year and Braves in the World Series. And I got to tell you, Rachel, I admire you for when Robbie calls Jeff, who's me, his uncles, and talks about the game. Rachel, there's nothing more beautiful than seeing you in an Atlanta Braves t-shirt with an Atlanta Braves cap. You are absolutely stunning. Once again, everybody, thank you so much for coming. It's wonderful for you to be here, and I will hand the microphone over to the next more capable person you meet.
A big round of applause for Robbie's mom and dad.
Por lo que más tú quieras, hasta cuando, hasta cuando. Y así pasan los días, y yo desde esperando, y tú no contestando. Quizás, quizás, quizás.
Tonight.
Yes, you're lovely with your eyes so warm and your cheeks so soft.
Only you have that magic technique.
Don't go anywhere, because something very, very special is about to happen. And Rachel and Rami told me that it's going to be so much more special if all their friends would come up around the dance floor, ladies and gentlemen. I need everybody to get up and come up here around the dance floor right now as we welcome our couple, Rachel and Rami, for their first dance. Ladies and gentlemen, I need more people around the dance floor. Come on up. Come on up. This is something very special. We won't see this again. Please welcome Rachel and Rami to the dance floor.
I can bear with you. esta manera, no se viene la culpa. Llega de esa manera, no tener la culpa. Amor comprenda, amor en el pasado. Ven, 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 ven,
yeah. você nada. Ai, se eu te pego, ai, ai, se eu te pego. Delícia, delícia, assim você nada. Ai, se eu te pego, ai, se eu te pego. Você me mata, ai se eu te pego, ai, ai se eu te pego. Delícia, delícia, assim você me mata, ai se eu te pego, ai, se eu te pego. Nossa, nossa, assim você me mata, ai se eu te pego, ai, ai se eu te pego. Delícia, delícia, assim você me mata, ai se eu te pego, ai.
If I take you away. Time out there. to please. We gotta kill this switch. You're from the 70s, but I'm a 90s bitch.
Yeah!
just beautiful. Right on. Okay, so we got something else special for you. Give me 1 second here. Is everybody having a good time tonight? I hope so. Okay. So right now, I need to get up on the stage here for a speech. I need Abe Cooper with Will Skolnick, Robbie's friends. Come on, guys, you can make a little bit noise in that. Let's go. All right, who's first?
So Robbie insisted that I make this short, sweet, and appropriate, so I'll do my best to do so. You know, first and foremost, thank you to the Arizon and Abrams family for this beautiful evening, because obviously without them, we wouldn't be here. You know, tonight's the kind of night where you have to also think about those who are not here with us, but are here in our thoughts, and one particular person comes to mind. His name is Oyinye. Table 11 knows exactly who I'm talking about. Oyinye is the greedy bouncer that we used to pay off at Paul's Casablanca. I mean, this guy probably made 50 grand off our crew. So if it wasn't for that, and particularly our friend Nader, who always hooked up that syndication, we would have never gotten in that night, and we would, of course, never have this wonderful matrimony that is today. So I'm Abe Cooper, and I am, as Robbie would characterize, the de facto non-family, but like family, best man. I've known Robbie for almost 25 years. We both grew up in Harrison, New York, but the relationship and bond that I think we have today really didn't start until 2008. I had spent the brunt of my high school years in boarding school, and when I came back to Harrison senior year, a week before classes, I saw Robbie at Sal's Pizza, and he was slightly taller, still good looking, very smart, but equally, if not more, cartoonishly goofy as when I first met him when he moved from Dunwoody. That said, I accepted his pursuit of friendship, and I would say we were attached at the hip. I mean, truly. Through high school, he went to Georgetown, I went to GW, and all the way through Manhattan, where we were roommates for 7 years. I'm really proud to say that we went through some of life's most pivotal and complex moments together, both professionally and socially. And, you know, I'm just so proud of him and to who he's become as a person, as a professional. You know, I mean, words can't even describe it. It's so hard to do in such a short period of time, but he's such a special guy to me. It all changed when we had a night out at Gitano, and let's just say that that night had its sequences of oddities and obscurities and nuances. And knowing the friend that Robbie is, when we went to Gitano with our friends who were at Table 11, Robbie's the kind of guy who would always support me. He would counsel me on professional matters, personal matters, dating matters, and in fact, that night, we were supposed to meet with a lady friend at another venue, and that fell through, and Robbie's the kind of guy, he said, Abe, after dinner with our jolling buddies, you let us know, like, let me know when. It ended up falling through. We saw some family friends from Harrison who were on acid, I think, in Tribeca, we had some weird moments, but I'll never forget when Robbie met Rachel. And yes, I wouldn't call on a date with Josh's ex-girlfriend, but she was invited to the venue. She used to always talk about you. I mean, listen, she tried to get me very jealous, you know, you know, when Robbie met Rachel, and I swear, to this day, I won't forget it, Robbie came up to me in his tight scarf, which, by the way, he got all his going out decor from me, and it was actually called a fondue, it was a summer scarf. Rachel, he wasn't... Rachel, I didn't get my boy into some winter scarf. It was like April 29th. This was an Ascot fondue from, like, Stefano Ricci across from the SK office he got. This was like, you know, this wasn't a scarf. But I know, but Robbie, his eyes were bulging after he met Rachel, and he said, man, I gotta date that girl. And Robbie, listen, we were single bachelors in New York for a long time. We went out hard. Robbie didn't say things like that. No, seriously, I mean, we did. But I knew at that point that something, may have changed. And I'm proud to say that I've been with Robbie and Rachel from quite literally the beginning. And I'm just so happy that you two found each other. And, you know, although you haven't spent most of your relationship here in New York, it's so evident as to how much of a partnership you guys have. Have you been able to grow with each other over the last 2 years? And I'll never forget it. I mean, with Robbie, I could tell you were the one for him. It's probably summer 2019. Just the way he was talking about you, you're obviously beautiful. You come from a great family. You're smart. But he didn't even say that. What he said was, I'm just so happy when I'm with her. And everything's just better when I'm with her. And that's how you know you found your life partner. Because everything else, the exterior, it's meaningless at the end of the day. It's just like, do you love to spend every waking moment with that person? So I knew fairly early on that this was, you were the one. And I'm just so proud to have you as a friend, Robbie. You categorically changed my life for the better. I love having my life. And Rachel, I hope to consider you now a sister by way of my relationship with Robbie. And, all the best. I can't wait to see the family you create, the household. Maybe we'll get you the Upper East Side. I know you ended up moving to Brooklyn. That's okay. That was disappointing to me. Robbie knew that. But it's okay. But I love you guys so much. And I'm just so happy. And all the best. L'chaim.
Very, very nice.
All right. We all got educated earlier about following acts, right? Okay, good. I'm really happy to be here, Robbie and Rachel. Robbie, we have spent so much time together over the last decade, from freshman year at Georgetown to our investment banking days to living in New York City. And ever since you met Rachel, I really noticed the best changes in you. You truly go through life with ease and joy that I had never seen before. And I'm sure this will allow you to take advantage of all the opportunities and overcome all the challenges that lay ahead. So as your self-described intelligent friend from Georgetown, I wanted to end with an ancient Chinese proverb that says, being loved deeply gives you strength, and loving someone deeply gives you courage. And I know you and Rachel have all the strength and courage for amazing decades ahead. Congratulations. Cheers to Robbie and Rachel Abrams.
Thank you. That was wonderful. Please give it up for Abe and Will, everybody. All right. And now it's time for a speech from Rachel's siblings. Please give a warm welcome to Lily and Joshua Eberzahn.
All right, 1 second. All right, hi everyone. As most of you hopefully know by now, I'm Rachel's little sister, Lily. As you all will recognize by the time I finish this speech, there's an overarching theme of how cool Rachel is. And I totally mean that from the bottom of my heart, so I hope you believe me, because I mean it. So to start off, I'd like to state that Rachel and my brother Josh, I'll give him some credit, are the reason I exist today. My parents were never planning on having more than 2 children, but thanks to my older siblings who begged and pleaded, and 10 times over begged and pleaded them, I am here today. So that's a pretty cool thing of you to do. Thank you. That in itself is pretty cool, but it gets even better from here. As those of you who know us Afrazons, it is never quiet nor dull in our home. Growing up was entertaining to say the least, with Josh's infamous pranks, the piano playing constantly throughout the house and practically living on an animal farm, there was never a moment of peace. But among all of that chaos was Rachel, my cool, calm, and collected older sister. Don't get me wrong, Rachel was entertaining as any. She would put on skits and dances and shows and force me to be a part of all of them, which I really enjoyed. But when all the chaos got to be too much, I looked towards Rachel as a calming force in all of the noise. I wished to be able to step back and view life the way she did, and found myself wishing to be like her in many more ways than one. Like the small things, like the music she listened to, which was really hard to ignore because she blasted it throughout the house 24/7. The shows she watched, like One Tree Hill, which everyone knew she was obsessed with, and her super cool friends. For context, every time Rachel's friends came over, I would annoy the hell out of them. It's because I wanted to be a part of it all of her life, because everything she did epitomized what I wanted to be when I grew up, and that was my older sister. And then, after all of that, Rachel went and did the coolest thing imaginable. She went to university in Switzerland. At this point, Rachel's coolness factor was at a 10 out of 10. There was no way she could ever surpass that level of coolness in my eyes. And yet again, I was proven wrong when Rachel met Robbie, who was already cool to begin with. Their cumulative coolness factor was off the charts. Robbie fit perfectly into the chaotic dynamic of our family. Seeing Robbie and Rachel's relationship grow from when we first met him till today has shown me just how well they work as a team and how two people can grow together. Although two very different personalities, their values and morals perfectly align, and the two complement each other in all ways possible. Rach, I'm so proud to see you grow up to be such an incredible sister, daughter, and now wife, and I wish you both the world, which is what both of you deserve. I don't say it often enough, and I wish I did, but I love you both very much, and I hold you both dearly to my heart. Congratulations, and I really hope you enjoy your honeymoon in Switzerland, in Italy, which sounds pretty cool to me. Cheers to that.
All right. It was really nice. Give it up for Josh, everybody.
Well, I'm not sure what I can say that hasn't already been said. I'll say a couple stories about, I'll start off with Robbie and how we've gotten to know one another over time. Robbie stepped into my life in 2019, and I remember it well because I'd come home to Avon to visit my family in Central Connecticut, and never met him before. This was like a Friday night, and I think you guys were already in bed, and got up on a Saturday morning and looking for Robbie and Rachel, and I think they probably slept in a little bit. It was around like 10 o'clock, and then I see this figure come down the stairs in kind of a nice, comfortable robe. It looked like he just took a shower, comfortable, you know, stepped into the kitchen, and he opened up the eggs, and he took out some onions and some peppers. And he turned to me, and he goes, "You want anything? You want an omelet, cheese, pepper? I'm making something." And I'm like, either this guy is the biggest jerk in the world, or he's completely clueless. And I actually was somewhere, it was even better. He was just an amazing person who is comfortable everywhere that he goes. And that was something I had to learn about Robbie. But I just remember thinking, in 18 years I lived in that house, and I don't think I've ever been as comfortable as Robbie was. And that first day, just watching him go. And then the second day that I met, or second time, maybe third time I met Robbie, I'd flown to Florida to spend time with the family, and there he was again, obviously. I remember I flew in, and I recognized the shirt that he was wearing. And it was a beautiful kind of a blue polo, and I swore that I'd seen it before. But obviously, you know, Robbie had flown in, they kind of dropped everything, moved to Miami, they didn't take any clothes with them or anything, it was COVID. So, you know, he felt appropriate to permanently, you know, borrow my entire closet, which I still haven't gotten back. I don't think I got that. And I remember, you know, and this is where I learned Robbie was a practical jokester, but I was looking at him, he noticed I was looking at the shirt, and he said, you know, he kind of looked at me and says, "You know, I noticed you're looking at the shirt. So this is my favorite shirt." He said, "If you want one, I can get you one just like that." I know where to get it. But honestly, we spent so much time together with, you know, Robbie going through the house in Connecticut. As he says, it's his real estate portfolio. And he has a pretty significant one that he's acquired. But what I got to learn about Robbie is, and this was why this time together was so important, was that he's an amazing human being, an amazing man. I learned that he's caring. I learned that he's extremely loyal, not just to Rachel, but also to his family. I learned that he's hardworking, he's disciplined. I learned a lot of amazing things about Robbie. And for me, honestly, I've never had a brother before, so I'd like to consider Robbie being a brother that I never had, so thank you, Robbie. Rachel, I'm not even sure what to say about Rachel. You know, I think of a phrase, which is that your siblings are your very first best friend. And that's very important to remember. And I think that's very true with Rachel and me, and Lily, obviously, as well. That we're all extremely close. We're all each other's best friends. And we've been through, you know, our entire lives. So I've seen everything. I saw, you know, your first steps. I saw the first time that, you know, you went to school. You know, first time that you got a bad grade. I remember when you went off to college. I remember when you graduated college. I mean, I've seen literally everything from start to finish. And the only thing that I can say, the word that comes to mind right now as I look at Rachel is I'm very proud to be her brother. I'm gonna get emotional, but I'm very proud of, you know, who she's become and who she will become. Just very, very proud of her. I see Rachel and Robbie together, and what's great about them is they really don't need anybody else. I mean, if you see them in action, they love spending time with family, they love calling us. Well, actually, Robbie calls, Rachel doesn't call. But they love spending time with family, but they don't really need anybody. They're just amongst themselves, and that's the strength of the relationship. That's something that's gonna last for the rest of your guys' lives. So, L'chaim, guys, so proud to be here. Thank you very much. Thank you. L'chaim, everyone. Thank you so much. L'chaim, guys. Huh?
I have the honor of singing this song for you guys while you're cutting the cake. So I'm gonna turn it over to my partner, DJ Teddy Brown, which will direct you on what to do.
clapping. They gotta keep kissing it nice and loud, nice and loud. Come on. Clap it up, clap it up, clap it up. Yes, keep going, they're not stopping. Yes, 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 yes. More, more. Relationship goals right here, everybody. That is the goal. Congratulations. Give it up for Robbie and Rachel out in their wedding cake.
So right now, we're going to ask Robbie to find your mom as we invite you up on the stage or up on the dance floor for the mother and son dance. To the dance floor.
Una notte a Napoli, con la luna in mare, ho incontrato un angelo che non poteva più volare. Una notte a Napoli.
Big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Make them feel love in this house.
Oh,
Tonight, and just incredible seeing everyone here. You know, it's pretty surreal as I think about it, just having all these pockets of my life under the roof here at one time. Yeah, friends, childhood friends, college friends, friends from all over, family from all over, colleagues, of course my immediate family, but now my new an additional immediate family. You've probably noticed the theme here, but really just couldn't ask for a better set of in-laws, just so unbelievably welcoming to me, and truly love them and feel like they are my newest family. Just happy to be celebrating this year with everyone today. I'll keep it brief, but just so thankful for you all making the trip out here. And making this honestly the most special night of our lives. Rachel, I love you so much and just honestly so happy to be celebrating this with you and everyone closest to us in our life.
Amen.
I love it. Rachel, short and sweet. Baby. That was great. You guys feeling good?
Yeah.
Are you ready to dance more?
Come on out. Just one. up, up, turn, you up. Say, come on, dance.
You're
too sexy,
then pour it.
Too freaky,
then roll it.
You're fret about, just show me. Come on, dance.
You're
too sexy, then throw it.
We're setting up, we in the spot.
Don't believe, just put your head on. Sky, the show of sky, the stars.
Robbie and Rachel Abrams, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations! All right, I'm gonna tell everybody. Please tell all the people that the boss is going up the bus, the bus. B-U-S-S, okay. It's going up to the city, and about to leave. Oh my God, I can't read this. The bus is about to leave to the city. Your dessert is outside. Grab some dessert.
Day in Amalfi. Al Monastero Santa Rosa and Donna Stella Pizza. Amalfi.
Thank you. na na.